Hey guys, this is Austin, and today it is time for our 2019 gaming PC build tutorial with a very special guest, Mr. John Rettinger, the OG of Tech YouTube, and I don't say that lightly.
I'm Team Krusty. At this point, been doing it for so long. So I have a confession. This is embarrassing. Not only have I never built a gaming PC, I have actually never built a computer ever.
You gotta give yourself some credit. Like, you've done like RAM upgrades and like that kind of stuff.
I've done that kind of stuff, and I know the components, but I have never actually like
physically put it together.
Put them all together myself.
So we pretty much every year when we do our PC build tutorial, we try to pick like a different variety of parts. So this one's a very standard build. So it's a full size chassis. We have like the hard drive, we have the SSD, a little bit of everything that you would typically do. But the most important thing here is that we actually have to put it together. So when it comes to building a gaming PC, you need exactly one tool, a screwdriver. So I will bestow this upon you.
So I know what this is.
Yes.
I'm prepared for this part
okay.
of the build.
You've unboxed the thing or two in your day. I'm not worried
about
this.
There we go, look at that.
That's pretty good, actually. So this is the Fractal Design Focus G. And when it comes to building a PC, the actual case itself doesn't make a huge difference. So the main thing is to look for the size. So let's flip this over.
So is this computer gonna find a home after I destroy it?
We'll see about that. We'll All see, right. we'll have to build the system
okay.
first. We'll see if it actually survives.
Yeah. I meant to do that?
It's okay.
We're 5 minutes in, I've already broken something. All right.
So most of the time when you're buying a case, a lot of the hardware comes with it. You'll see a couple of other screws come with, like for example, the power supply, but just make sure you don't lose this. We will need this a little bit later. But besides that, there's really not a whole lot to do besides install the power supply. So something like this is a 600 watt EVGA unit. It costs somewhere in the neighborhood of like $50 or so. You can get cheaper 600 watt units, but they will catch on fire. I'm not even kidding. Like, some of the really cheap units will straight up last like 3 months and legitimately can catch on fire, ruin your components. This is not an area to save a lot of money. Get something that's decent, 80 plus, and make sure it has enough power for your components, right? So what we're running here, 600 watts will be just fine.
So how do you make sure it's gonna have enough power?
So there's PC Part Picker has a great calculator, so you can plug in all your parts, right? So generally speaking, it's your CPU and your graphics card. Those are like the main components. And if you wanna do any overclocking, you always wanna have some headroom, but that will generally give you a good sort of ballpark of, oh, it's gonna pull 300 watts or 500 watts or whatever the case is. Usually just get something that's a little bit over what you need or a fair bit over because it doesn't hurt and you never know if you wanna do any upgrades.
Do I have to like introduce myself before I mount it? Or?
No.
We're good just to go ahead and do it? It's a PG channel.
So for a case like this, if you take a look, we actually have a grate on the bottom. So we can put the power supply face down, but some power supplies would need to be face up. For example, if it's on the top of the case, just make sure that when you see this fan, it has access to at least some airflow.
Is it pulling air in or pushing it out?
It's pulling it in and it's pushing it out the back. So one good tip when you're installing any kind of hardware, this is not even like a PC specific thing, do the corners. So start with this corner, then do this one, and this one. That way you're always applying even pressure. That's something that's nice for computers, but like legit, like if you're putting like tires on your car or anything like that, doing like sort of a cross pattern is always a good idea.
So my initial idea is why I want to build a PC. My mom just retired. She'd been running my dad's office for years and their PC at home is like running Windows 7 and it's aging. And she's like, I need to get a new computer. I was like, all right, like, at some point I gotta man up and be like, I can build a computer. Like, it's almost embarrassing that I'd never done it. So I'm gonna take this knowledge.
And you're gonna get mom hooked up with the sweet
system.
And
I'm gonna build a computer for my mom.
So this is step one, installing the power supply. We can actually set this off to the side now and start putting together the motherboard.
Okay.
So with this system, I opted to go for Ryzen. As far as I'm concerned, especially in this sort of like middle budget area, Ryzen's basically the way to go. So we are using the Ryzen 5 2600X. I actually usually recommend the 2600 because this guy is a little bit more expensive and it's not totally worth the price, but I had one, so. So you're probably aware, but essentially a motherboard is kind of what everything touches, right? So we have our processor in here, our RAM, graphics card, SSDs, everything pretty much attaches to the motherboard in some way. So the first step is to work on our CPU.
Okay.
So this is the built-in stock cooler that comes with the processor.
Okay.
So if you look at this bit right here, that's thermal paste. Don't touch that. Basically, that's going to be what makes a nice solid connection with our CPU. Now, this is the part of a build that I think most people get really anxious about. So the CPU, as you can see, it's got all these like little pins and stuff, and you have to be very careful with it. But realistically, probably the easiest component to install. It's literally like, it's gonna take you 5 seconds.
I mean, it might take you 5 seconds.
Okay.
Let's see.
I have faith.
Okay.
So this area in the middle of the motherboard is where our CPU socket goes. All you do is just pull that arm back and pull it all the way up to the
top. And this will look the same on pretty much any motherboard, right?
Like, it's slightly different between AMD and Intel. Very similar, though.
Okay. I feel like I'm bringing the T1000 to life here.
Well, you kind of are. So just gently
sit
down. You're a little off.
Am I off?
There you go. Okay. So all we need to do now is just push this arm down.
Okay.
We're installed.
Got it.
Simple as that. Now it's time to put in our CPU cooler. I might need a bigger screwdriver. Yeah, I'm gonna grab a bigger screwdriver. Hang on a second.
I'll go ahead and take this opportunity to say I was extremely nervous putting in that processor. Hopefully it didn't show. Like RAM I've done, but never the processor. Nervous? All right, Austin coming back. I gotta be quiet now. Don't tell him I was nervous, okay? I was totally cool putting in that processor.
I'll be totally honest, I told you to do it the wrong way at first. It was to the side, and I realized that I looked over at it that it actually goes that way. So that was my bad.
Not on me.
Okay, we'll cut that part out of the video. So with our back plate fully in the right zone, we're good to put this in. So all you do is line up so you can see that the screws, they have little springs on them so they're tensioned.
Easy.
Before you set it down though, keep in mind that you have thermal paste here.
Yes.
The thermal paste, once it applies, you just think about it like this. You wanna have even pressure as you push it down.
Okay.
So basically when you set it down, try not to move it too much, right? So try to like line it up and then put some pressure to kind of make sure that this is making a very solid seal with our
processor. Does it need a lot of pressure?
It doesn't need a lot, but you don't want it to be like wiggling around because then the thermal paste starts to slide and kind of get uneven, you can get air bubbles. So after a bit of tightening to make sure the screws are very evenly placed, not your fault, something super easy to happen.
Austin's too nice to say it's not my fault.
No, it's totally, totally easy to happen. It was particularly finicky, but the main thing is the actual cooler is on. Next, we need to plug in the actual fan.
Okay.
So it's the CPU fan header right here. It's you see these two notches?
Yeah.
So it only goes in one way. So literally just plug it in.
I can handle it.
I believe in you. Hey!
Nailed it.
All right, nice. Next up is the fun part, installing RAM.
I've done RAM before.
Okay, I will let you have at it.
So with Austin Evans and his attention to detail, look at that. The RAM.
I was hoping it's the right size. It's a little too bright, I think.
Like, when you open it up, it should match and look beautiful. It's the Steve Jobs.
Dude, I always do like the worst color coordinating. Like,
look at that.
That's pretty good. So we have 16 gigs of DDR4. So one of the things you should keep in mind specifically when you're building Ryzen systems is that the speed of the memory is important. Not even just for like integrated graphics or something, which this does not have, but it just speeds up the entire Ryzen system and gets a little bit more out of that CPU. So usually I would like to budget a little bit more money towards some fast RAM here. So 3000 megahertz is pretty quick for DDR4, but importantly, it's also blue. So this uses dual channel memory, or this can utilize dual channel memory. So you wanna set it in channel 1 and channel 3 typically.
Okay.
So you can check the motherboard again to be sure. And if there's only 2 DIMM slots, it's super straightforward. But for this, we're gonna put it in 1 and 3. So I'm gonna hand you this.
You can do that.
So I'm just gonna open up the little retention pen, so it's pretty straightforward.
Okay.
And then I think you,
just kinda drop
is that
in.
The right way? You might have flipped it. I think you need to flip it.
There we go.
There you go. Hey, there we go.
Boom.
All right.
Rammed.
Rammed up. Next up is our SSD. So we're doing a couple things here. So we are using a standard hard drive, but you always want to use an SSD pretty much for any build. Like, I don't really recommend any Windows PC or any computer in general right now without some kind of SSD.
Okay.
Especially considering the SSDs have gotten cheap. This is a 500 gigabyte M.2 drive, so it's proper fast, and this costs like $80. So there's two tiny little screws. So the bigger guy, you can just literally hand tighten into that hole.
Okay.
And then the other screw will hold the drive into place.
Okay.
So now we need to install the actual M.2 drive.
Got it right here.
So if you take it, you'll see the gold connectors. It only goes in one way because there's a little notch.
Easy.
So the label is facing up in this case. So just like basically just rest it in. So when it's in, you can actually see that like there's a little bit of tension. So the screw is what's gonna hold that down. That's actually pretty much all we need to do with this. Now we can actually install it into the case.
Let's do it.
Before we do that, we do want to install our I/O shield. So this is essentially, if you imagine the ports right here, this kind of goes on top of the ports, something like this. You want to put this in beforehand, because otherwise,
makes sense.
It doesn't fit. And believe me when I say, I've installed quite a few motherboards, got it all screwed in, then realized I forgot this part. So do this first. So the next step is to install our standoffs. Try to get them as tight as you can.
Okay.
It doesn't make a huge difference right now, but if you ever need to pull out the motherboard and you don't get your standoffs all the way in, the standoffs will like pull out with the board. It's this huge hassle, you have to use pliers. All right, so now that our standoffs are in place, we can put the motherboard in. So this part gets a little bit annoying, mostly because it's not really anything that you need to worry about. I mean, don't like scrape it on the inside of the case, but you gotta get it lined up just right, and sometimes it doesn't. Okay. And it is, by the way, totally okay as long as you have your CPU cooler in correctly to hold it by this. It's fine.
That was making me anxious. I'm glad you said that.
And then you see all the ports right here? Mm-hmm. We wanna make sure that we're lining up with those ports. So we don't have to get it perfectly first try, but we want to get it in the ballpark.
Okay.
So once you make sure that all of your ports are lined up on the back and that no tabs or anything are there, you also want to take a visual look to make sure that all of your screw holes are lined up. So when you have that center post, typically speaking, you're going to be pretty close to being ready.
Yeah.
And so with this one, we look pretty much good to go. So now we can actually start screwing it into place. Look at Mr. Rettinger building a PC over here, man. Look at
so
that.
So this is a bucket list.
So with that, we can pick it up right, and assuming it doesn't all come crashing
over.
Down.
It's like immediately.
So you can definitely see the beginnings of the build, right? I mean, we've got our power supply, we've got our motherboard with almost all of our components involved. There's still a lot of cabling and stuff we need to work on. But at this point, you can kind of take a breath, go, hey, look,
nailed
you got
it.
Something that's starting to resemble a PC. Now, this is a RX 590. This is actually a card that I will be completely honest, I mostly picked because it's a decent card, but it's blue. And it matches the rest of the system.
Look at the detail that you get from Austin Evans.
Woo!
Look at that.
Oh, dude.
I want bumper stickers made that say Austin Cares.
So if you guys are not familiar with the 590, this is essentially a 580 that has been heavily overclocked. And that is way bigger than I thought. Look at the size of the heat pipes. For a card, which is realistically not an insanely powerful card, that's a lot of cooling. This is actually really simple. Before we install it, all we need to do is we need to take out the PCI covers. So it's literally just as simple as unscrewing these two and it should slide right in.
Okay.
So you know, of course, at the end, we're gonna have to name it, right?
Yeah.
You should start thinking about names in your
already
head.
This is like gonna be my third kid.
Whoa, man.
Naming it.
Whoa, that's a little too much pressure.
Sure.
So we actually are almost done installing components in the case. So we still need to do cable management, but before we do that, we have to install our hard drive. Now this is actually strictly not necessary. Well, with what we have in here right now with the SSD, this is an optional thing, but I think a lot of people enjoy installing hard drives just to get some extra capacity, or if you don't want to use an SSD, although you should, you can run the OS off of a hard drive. So all you do is, because it's a toolless drive, you see it's got these little like notches. So you just want to make sure that the actual connectors, the SATA connectors are facing in the back so we can plug it in. So I'll let you do it, but it literally just lines up with the metal holes and it just holds in. Now it's time to actually start cabling things up.
Okay.
It seems intimidating, it seems scary. Not gonna be that bad. So we have a little bit of space back here. So usually you wanna route as many cables behind and then bring them back, right? So if we look over here, we're gonna take these two cables and just run them through the hole.
So does this one plug into the top? Like it goes like, kind of like
it's
this?
Imagine it's one connector.
Okay,
yeah.
Got it.
So it's a 20+4, but you always use it together. Next up we have our CPU power. So this is a 4+4. Now this is something that should be plugging in right up here. So I'm going to run it directly up and pass it through to you.
Got it.
Next, let's work through some of these other cables. This is called SATA. So we actually have two, which look identical, right? Yeah. So this is what we need to run to our hard drive. If we weren't using a hard drive or an SSD that was like in this bay, we wouldn't need this, but we do need this.
Okay.
So if you want to unwrap that guy.
Got it.
So actually, if you look to the side here, you'll see that SATA 1, SATA 2, peripheral, and VGA.
Okay.
I would plug it into SATA 2, mostly just so that kind of we can get a little bit of a cleaner cable run. So you can see that it's sort of this long connector, but it's got a little notch on the end.
Yeah.
So that corresponds to the hard drive right here. All you do is literally just line it up, press it in. It doesn't click, but just make sure it's seated all the way. The next thing, and arguably really the more important thing, is we need to make sure that we have plenty of power for our graphics card. So actually, this is a good point to kind of mention. So you see this is starting to get a little tangled?
Yeah.
You actually want to do your best to kind of flatten these cables now, because it will make your life easier later. And especially if you see them like start to like stack on top of each other, try to make sure there's a little bit of space, because the side panel won't go on if you have like three cables on top. So what we need to do is we need to use almost all of them except for this one. So you put it together.
That's like one connector.
Yeah, so when you do it, just make sure to pinch it. It's kind of annoying, but it's basically the same thing. Just plug in the 8-pin here.
Okay.
So power-wise, we're actually looking pretty good. Now it's time to start cabling all the little finicky things which are gonna take a while.
Okay.
So this case only has two fans, so there's a pair of fans up front. Now we need to run these cables. So there are multiple points on the motherboard, those fan headers we were talking about earlier. So our fans are now powered. Let's actually work our way down. So we have a bunch of panels that are up top here. So we wanna make sure our USB works, our audio, all that kind of stuff.
So how can you tell what's what?
It's all labeled. So you see this little connector right here, it says HD audio.
Okay.
So pretty much everything will say what it is. So when you're doing these sort of smaller connectors on the board, I like working from left to right, because basically if you do a bunch of stuff on the right, it's kind of harder to run. So with that, it should just be as simple as plugging into the AAFP port right here. So you can see how it's like, it's a 10 pens, but there's one knocked out.
Yeah.
You can't put it in the wrong way. So just make sure that one row with the four is on top.
Okay.
So one thing to note, as you do all this cable management, it's very easy to have something that's either not correct or maybe not all the way in. So once we test and like turn on the system, if you see like your USB's port's not working or your audio port's not working or whatever, just go back and double check the cable. 9 times out of 10, it's not something broken. It's just like a little bit loose or something. Next up is our USB 3 header. Now I will say one thing about this, it looks bigger and easier, and it is easier, but I have broken so many of these connectors, specifically when you pull it out, like this is just not a well-designed thing. So there's a notch on the bottom, so you'll see that it corresponds with this guy right here, so you'd wanna put the notch up top.
And before you plug it in, shout one out to the blue.
Oh yeah, USB 3. Hey. Here comes the most fiddly part of any PC build. These guys.
What are those things?
These are all of our front panel connectors.
Okay.
So we have our power switch, reset switch, our hard drive LED, and our power LED.
Mm.
So if you take a look at the cables, you'll see if you flip it over that there's a little arrow. The arrows denote positive. So on this pen out, you will see the positive and negative. Okay. Anytime you see positive, you know that it's the little arrow that is going to denote. So just use that as your frame of reference.
Okay.
There's a SATA cable left, and I think that's going to be it. So you can see that it's a smaller guy, and it has a notch. Now this actually does click in.
Okay.
So if you look on the side here, you'll see all of our SATA ports.
Yeah.
So I'll plug it into SATA 1. So you want to plug this guy in here.
Got it.
And then you see on the back side of the hard drive, this goes in right here.
So there you go.
There we go.
In.
That, my friend, is what should be a completed PC build. Now, of course, we need to do a lot of cable management, but don't do any of that until you actually test to see if it works. Because if it doesn't, this thing is coming back apart.
All right, it's the moment of truth.
All right, 3, 2, 1. Hey!
Oh, it's all light.
Excellent sign. So our CPU fan's spinning. Only one of our fans here is spinning. We'll have to fix that. I'm pointing at the graphics card. Oh, dude, look how cool that looks.
Those blue lights.
We did it. So now comes the hard part, which is waiting the roughly 10 to 18 minutes it takes for it to post. It's not actually 18 minutes. It should take like 30 seconds, but it feels like 18 minutes. Oh,
there it is.
Immediate.
So my 3-year-old, whenever he gets excited, he always yells, "Ma did it." he can't get the words out. So I feel like, "Ma did it."
Oh, dude, there we go. We got our Ryzen 5 2600X. We have 16 gigs showing up. 2 keyboards and mice. I'm not sure why it shows 2, but it's fine. We have built ourselves a game PC. High five, man.
We did it.
So the best part is we didn't build this just for no reason. This is yours to take home to your parents.
What?
Yes.
This is for mom?
This is for mom. Mom has a dope gaming
PC
now.
Mom's getting a... That's unnecessary, but very, very appreciated. She's gonna appreciate the blue. I'm gonna get footage of me giving it to her and replacing her Windows 7 computer.
That's great. Okay, cool. If you guys enjoyed this video, definitely be sure to subscribe, not only here, but also to John Rettinger's super shiny, rebranded new channel.
Yeah.
A lot of changes over there. And as always, if you guys want to know any more about any of the parts we use, the links will be in the description. Other links to a couple of other tutorials if you want to check out more information. But if you want to learn how to build a PC, hopefully this has been helpful. John, play us out, please.
And if I can do it, you can do it too.
Those are some motivational words right there.
I mean it.